I'm 2-3 now. I'm 2-2-3. So, friends, I've decided to most likely quit my law studies as a result of the inefficiencies and frustrations and turmoil of having to deal with the course materials in contract law. And I think I made a decision which has been rather inevitable. It was pretty much always going to happen. And I didn't know that it was going to happen until I actually tried. So, as they say, if you never go, you'll never know. But it was always going to happen because I didn't like the lecturer, the Irish lecturer, and I didn't like the way the other lecturer explained things and the amount of offal and, I don't know, congealment and just complete irrelevance of so much of the material to our to what we really had to do in this course, and just so much material to be read and consumed, and it was fun in some ways, but ultimately, I mean, there was just too much material, and it was just too much of a mind bender, and it's not intellectual fodder, it's more like just stuff that you have to know, which is not really useful to you. So all these factors played against the fact that I was going to finish the course or the diploma. That's the sad news. That's the sad news. And the best news is, of course, that I'm liberated from those studies and I can do whatever I like now and feel much freer. So every day I just do what I can for this channel and consume my time with reading maybe books like this. I mean, this is a book that I read when I was about, I think I was 11 or 12. 11, most likely, when I was in year six, I read this book. And it's actually harder for me to read now than it was then because I don't have the concentration that I did have when I was a kid. When I read this book, it just feels so spaced out and none of the senses really matter. And it's called The Red King by Victor Gallaher. It's quite a renowned book in the Australian circles because it was shortlisted for a prize in 1990, which is when I read the book. But I mean, I can do things like that. I can use my computer, I can make TikTok videos, and I can read documentation and that sort of thing. But I'm far too free, and I have to decide what to do with myself. Obviously, writing poetry is a big part of my life, my lifestyle, and I get a lot out of that. But to construct a paradigm in which I'm actually every day fulfilling my potential is really, really difficult for me because I have so much free time. It's the opposite of what happened before when I had too much of a construct around my life where I didn't have free time that was enough to allow myself to experience a sense of liberation every day. So that's unfortunate. The balance is not there. I guess if I knew what I was doing and had a bucket list, if I was traveling, for example, if I wanted to, because I always wanted to travel, if I was going on with some kind of ethical business or something, I'm not sure. But all of these considerations. What else would I be doing? Reading a really, really good novel, something that I always wanted to do for a long time that I haven't done for ages. Working on the concept of living modelling and the ideas around ideology around living modelling and making videos about it. But the thing about living modelling is it's really hard to conceptualise and to develop a conceptualisation of that that will develop the idea and keep it ongoing with my audience, which is you guys. So, I am pretty much stalled in that idea unless I, type something on my computer and file it away in my living modeling file documentation. That will slowly develop, but it's a long-term project which I don't believe will ever fruitify into something completely, workable. Because it's a very nebulous sort of idea. One of the things I have to contend with in my day-to-day life is the fact that I'm not allowed to eat very much because I have to count my calories. But eating is something of a focus for me, because it's so fun to do, so much of an enticement for me. So I normally have 2 meals a day, but I try and make it so that my first meal of the day, which is about 10 or 12 o'clock in the morning, or just at noon, 12 o'clock, is the larger meal of the two, and then my meal in the afternoon at about 4:15 or 5 o'clock is much smaller or significantly smaller. Hopefully that system works for me, but it's been working okay, but I haven't lost much weight or any weight in the last 6 to 12, maybe even 18 months, but due to the fact that I haven't been able to break that 95, 98 kilogram barrier and eat really, really smallish kind of meals. I've been really too much tended to eat so much food. So, this is called the given circumstances of my life. My life is rather unique compared to a lot of other people's because I don't have many people that I engage in on a regular basis. I don't have children, I don't have dependents, I don't have a dog or a cat or even I don't own any, fishes. And I would never want to own a fish like that and enslave a fish like that. But the given circumstances are that I have a lot of free time. I don't have much money. I can't do whatever I like. But I do have the ability to compose things on my laptop or go to the libraries where I am now, for example, or go to, shops or something. The big question, philosophical question, is should I create a bucket list? Should I have things to get on with and to do in my life, which will bring significance to my life? These things are not easy questions to ask, and we have to keep asking them in order to create significance for my life. I am, of course, somewhat an activist for the animals, but it's not something that, as I mentioned in the previous video, which I'll link in above, the limiting factor is not time because I have a lot of time on my hands. So when I ask the question, what should I do with myself on a day-to-day basis? It's a very, very important question and one which will keep me sane for so long. I can write a novella, I can write a novel, but because I don't have any ideas for myself in that regard, I pretty much can't get on with that myself. I think one of the common complaints among people, especially those who have a day-to-day job, is I have too much to do and I don't have enough time on my hands. This is a predicament that I don't share with those people because the predicament for me is to have too much time on my hands. So yeah, it's a strange paradigm that I face for myself, and I just had to ask you the question, what should I do with myself on a day-to-day basis? And should I have a bucket list? Should I have things, ambitions, and so on? Yeah, these are all philosophical questions which are very valid and very worthwhile to ask. Okay, folks, that's all I have to say for myself today, and I wish you well. And in the next video, I will talk to you more about myself. Bye for now.